A host of the Netherlands Empire. Swarming over the beaches and boundaries, overwhelming the native troops.
The Japanese have just officially laid down their arms.
The concentration camp was about a half an hour away from the house that I was. It was at the outskirts of Jakarta. You know. Oh yeah, we picked us up in the truck. But we could carry, you know, everybody a little suitcase. But my mother had an Indonesian friend. And the Indonesian friend told my mom, if you have a big trunk and fill it up with your papers, with your silverware, you know, what you want to save. And she said, you have to bring that over to my house at night in the dark, somebody with a truck. And she said, I will keep that trunk for you when the war is over, then you get it back. And the church, we took books to the church, and we took paintings. We had a beautiful home. And so the paintings went to the church and my dad, his books. And so all that was at the church. If they picked you up in a truck that you could carry and bring you to a camp, that was all. You leave your house. I told my mom, don't look back, mom. Don't look back. Yeah, my poor mom. My dad was already picked up. He was somewhere in the jungle. And so, and me and my sisters and my mom, we went to the camp. And there, no bed, sleeping on the floor, one bathroom for about 20 people. You know, oh my gosh. But we had to work too. I had to work. Now, I had to work for the kitchen. And we had to clean the sewer out. Because with all those people, you know, going to the bathroom, and there was no more running water, we had to go on the corner by the street, pick up a bucket of water. First we were in the garage. And my sisters and me and my mom, but well, then, I don't know why, they moved us. And there we were in a big room, just like the dining room. And with all people, with all different people. So but there you sleep on the floor. And you know, my sister was 10, well, maybe 8 years old. She caught a chicken. And what are you going to do with a chicken? Everybody was after that chicken because they wanted to eat it. But you know, we didn't bring any pots and pans. We didn't know what we were going to do. So that chicken, everybody was after that chicken. And so we took the chicken with us to bed. Every night we took the chicken with us, and in the daytime I had a rope and put the chicken on the rope and tied it on a chair. And then we gave the chicken the same to eat what we ate. And when the war was over, I still had that chicken, and I gave the chicken away. I couldn't kill a chicken, you know.
Were you ever approached by the Japanese in the sense of becoming a comfort woman, or?
Oh yeah, I was ready for it. Oh, you are on a list. All the girls that are 18 and older and not married, they use you as a prostitute. And we were on the list because I was not 20 yet. But my older sister, I bet you, my older sister, it was a feisty fighter. If she had to put them there, they would have killed her. Because you have to be ready for the soldiers and everything, day and night. You could not wear any clothes, only a kimono. And if they come in your room and they use you, in the middle of the night, when the camp commander was moon sick, when it was full moon, I think he got crazy. And then he walked through the camp in a white thing, and then we all had to walk in our night clothes. We had to walk through the camp. Oh my God, in the dark. When the boys were going to be 15 or whatever, grown up, they take them out. And you know, one of the boys didn't want to go. They didn't want to leave their mother. Well, you can understand that. Growing up in the camp, and then they take you out. You kill them. In front of the mother.
They killed the boy?
Yeah. My labor lady had a little girl that I took for a ride in the stroller, and she died. And you see a little baby in a box on a table. They played the record for the little girl too. Yeah, my mom was the worst. My mom died, and see your mother going down, and they put her in an orange crate, close it with hammer and nails, and shoved it on a truck, and she was gone. We had a train behind the camp, was a train going, and it was a little hill, but you can look over the fence. And the train, somebody threw a message over in a rock. They wrote in a message, and they threw the rock out of the train over the fence by us. So we got messages for that, you know. And one message it said, if we are free and the war is over, we are going by and hang all the Allied flags out the window. So every morning, the ladies went to the hill and looked by the train. No, nothing. And then one time, there was. They had the flags out, the American flag, everywhere. And he said, oh, we are free.